I'm not going to take the GoPro out of the case because it's pretty much covered in snow, but that was fun and interesting. I actually went down this trail before. My buddy Vince was, his bike broke down and I had to leave him at camp. Come up here by myself. I was trying to make this loop, but I couldn't find the entrance to Trail 30. Now apparently, it's that way. So we're gonna go see if we can find the entrance. This is where we just came from. That takes you back up to the main gravel road. I think it's Sea Line that's up there. I don't know, I'll have all the map information after the video's over, so stay tuned. Yes, I'm tired. Alright, y'all.
Trail's supposed to go the other way. Ha ha. Whatever. I'll let y'all see how much work it is to start the DR350. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on a hard start. Whoa! That's a pretty decent hill climb on a good day. Today, no. your momentum.
Snowy day video number one. So the search for trail 30 continues. So as I posted in my other video for 19, Toman's Knob, I came out 101. I did not this time. I came up 19 not knowing which way I was going. When I got here, I realized where I was. As you can see in the snowy day video, realized where I was, went this way, tried to find it, didn't, came back, and then this is the hill climb. I'm pretty sure this is the hill climb that I had an epic fail on. That section right there, which still looks pretty wide in the video. It almost looked like a four-wheel drive trail, and I thought I hit that in the summertime, but didn't anyway. So a lot of that time was spent coming up this road, you know, going up this road and figuring out, and I, you know, looking at the map and then counting my turns and everything and trying to get back. Yeah, I ended up just recognizing where I was on Sea Lion and came back down. That portion's not in the video, but it was a fun day. Lots of work. I ended up doing, after all that, 19, and then the snowy day, doing the snowy day video was all the same day. On trail 19, Toman's Knob, and then trying to find the entrance to 30, which ended up not being able to happen because I was probably on it that one section where I went up and slapped the tree and had to go back down and went up again, get more momentum, and then ended up just turning around. I'm pretty sure that was the trail because there was a lot of man-made stuff, but in the snow I couldn't tell. So I will try it again when the weather is better. So like, subscribe, share, guys. That day, that's where I was. That day I ended up hitting Chute Trail. Most of the sections of Chute Trail, and Oh, the first time I went down trail 25, and then I came back around. Yeah, it was a long day. So I did all that, hit shoot trail 23, then hit 25, and then hit 22, which is the trail that takes you to back-to-back. And about three quarters of the way through that, I was done for the day and just found a gravel road and ended up coming back home. So, yeah, it was a pretty epic day. A lot of recording. I wasn't able to record any of 22 because my batteries went dead. So, yeah, like, subscribe, share, guys, and I'll see you next time. Go hard or go home. Talk to you later.